Hello everyone, this is Nitpicky Nerd, and today I want to discuss the new trailer of Star Trek Picard, which kind of revealed what apparently the plot of the whole season is going to be about. Apparently it's going to be another time travel story of the characters having to go back into the past to fix something which caused an alternate bad future, which they have to prevent or change back to how it's supposed to be, and Q is going to be involved in all of this somehow. And that's actually the only interesting thing in all of this, because we've seen this type of story so many times, not just in Star Trek, but in many other science fiction shows. Most recently, in the ending of season 2 of The Orville, there was also that kind of story of the timeline changing because of a change in the past, and the team having to find a way to fix it by going into the past. And Stargate SG-1 had a lot of episodes like that, and usually those episodes are very cool and interesting because it shakes things up. It's so unusual, because most of those shows had some kind of a formula of what the show is usually about, and then once in a while you have a strange episode in which characters can get killed off and the ships can explode, whole planets can explode, because in the end of that episode or that two-parter, everything gets reset and fixed, and showing an alternate timeline is also very fun because you can show like a mirror universe kind of stuff. Like, suddenly the Federation is an empire, now it's a dystopia, now all the good guys can play evil. And so that was always fun for that reason, because it was unusual, because it was the opposite of what the show usually was. But if we get a whole season of stuff like that before you even established what the galaxy is like normally, then maybe it won't be as fun if it's an entire season instead of one or two episodes like that. Because I always prefer Star Trek when it used to be uplifting, when it showed the bright future and all of that, but if you show all of it to be a dystopia all the time, then you don't have that sense. You don't watch a show about a place that you want to be in, that you want to live in. And that's one of the problems I had with all the recent Star Trek shows, which had a tendency to be much more dystopian and horrific and dark and depressing. And you know how I would do this season? Like, I would have Q show up and not show any changes from what we saw in season 1. Simply have Q show up and say that this is all wrong and not how it's supposed to be, and explain how it happened, and them having to go back and change it. Because season 1 already showed the dystopia. It already showed that everything went to shit, basically. The Federation is crappy, doing a lousy job. The entire galaxy is like the Wild West, with all these rangers going around and trying to stop genocidal Romulans harvesting people's Borg implants out while they're awake, torturing people, all that kind of dark, nasty stuff across most of season 1. That's what the show was about, so it's already a dystopia. So what they will probably show is that, no, suddenly the Federation is good again, Picard is back into being an admiral somehow. Even though he's a robot, he's now a golem Picard, but suddenly I guess Starfleet accepts him because they undid the ban of the androids for some reason, because they found out the Romulans were behind that. But you know, if the androids are so weak that can be so easily hacked, then they are still dangerous. What prevents anyone from hacking them again and causing a massive destruction again? So why is Starfleet so quick to unban the androids and making one of the androids into an admiral? So, I don't know, maybe that whole scene with Picard in uniform, maybe it's a flashback from before season 1, but he doesn't look de-aged, and so I guess it's in the present, and Raffi is there apparently, so I guess they made him an admiral again, and they're showing that the Federation is bright again, but then suddenly something changes, suddenly the timeline changes into a dystopia, suddenly the comm badges have that little sword symbol in them, which kind of reminds me of the Mirror Universe, but I doubt it will be the actual Mirror Universe, because the Empire doesn't exist in that point. As we saw in Deep Space Nine, it was also mentioned in season 3 of Discovery that the Terran Empire collapsed long ago, and it will just be too confusing, too convoluted to again focus on that specific parallel universe, and we know there are multiple parallel timelines and universes, so there's no point to pick the mirror one, but maybe they can do it in a similar style, maybe just show that the Federation changed into something more creepy. But again, I say we don't actually need to show the change. Simply have Q show up and say that's what happened already. Then it can be a way to fix all the crap we saw previously. But I doubt they will do it, because they will not admit their own mistake. But, you know, this will be good stuff, good material for a fan edit. Maybe in a fan edit, this will be an excellent way to explain all the crap we saw previously. And so that will be a good thing. And by the way, later on, I will talk about the season one fan edit. I have some news about that. I'll discuss it later. So anyway, having Q in the picture and have him talk about a messed up timeline, having to fix it, is a good idea because it will allow us to kind of erase whatever we did not like in the previous seasons, even in Discovery. And so it will be a good thing, even if it's not the intention. It's probably not the intention of the showrunners. I don't think they're going to erase anything we saw in season one. They're going to restore it all by the end. But we, the fans, can then later play with that and say maybe it did change. Maybe we don't know how much of it changed. So anything we hated, we can ignore later on and say it never really happened. It all happened in some other timeline. So that will be a good thing, even if it's not the intention of the show to fix the crap they did previously. So they're apparently doing a time travel story in which something causes something in the past to change the whole timeline. And Starfleet will now have those little swords in the symbol of Starfleet, which indicates something kind of empire-like. And Seven will apparently no longer have her Borg implants, which indicate that maybe she never got assimilated and she just lives a different life and yet somehow still has the memories. Maybe Q is the one who will move their consciousness into the other timeline with their memory of how things should be. And that's the biggest question I have. Will Q still have his powers? Because if he has his powers, then what does he need Picard or any of these guys for? If he's still omnipotent, he can do whatever he wants. He can fix everything by himself. So why would he need Picard's help to do it? Unless, once again, it's some kind of test for Picard, but that would be boring to repeat the same kind of stuff we saw already. If they're going to bring back Q, it's better be for something new and fresh. I don't want to see just the same exact stories again. That will be pointless. So if he's still omnipotent and just playing games, then it's not really that interesting anymore. What would make it interesting is either he doesn't have his powers at all, maybe he does still have the knowledge, all his memory, but maybe he lost his powers or became a human, or maybe he's facing against some other Q who is limiting his power, or something like that will shake things up and make it more exciting and more interesting and less predictable, with more of a sense of danger to the characters and all of that. And I guess this whole alternate timeline will also explain how Guinan will fit into the whole picture, because we know that Whoopi Goldberg will be in the show, at least I guess for one episode she might appear. So we know that Guinan can see alternate timelines, and so maybe Picard will visit Guinan to get her insights on what's going on, and so that might be interesting. I'm wondering how they will explain her age when she's from a species who ages much slower. I guess with Q it's easy to explain because we can just say that he chooses to look like that, but with Guinan that's kind of more problematic. I guess they can always de-age them digitally nowadays, but it's too expensive, so they won't do it. So they'll have to come up with excuses. With Q, I'm hoping that in the first scene when he appears, maybe first, that's what I would do. I would first show him to be young, and then choosing to morph into looking older. That will also be more interesting just in a science fiction, special effects kind of way, just to see that, and will explain his change of appearance in a satisfactory way, and I'm fine with him looking older as the actor does in the rest of the show. That's fine, but in the first scene I am hoping that they will show some kind of special effect, just because it's more interesting that way, and also to make sure everyone recognizes him, because you know, maybe some people haven't watched the old shows for decades, maybe they really wouldn't recognize him, and so it will be clever to first show a glimpse of him being young and then choosing to age himself and morph into the man we see in the trailer. And so that will be neat, but probably they won't do it because they're kind of cheap and lazy. We saw that in season one, that they're not really trying to look better, because you know, even the special effects were disappointing in season one in my opinion, compared to Star Trek Discovery, which at least had some nice special effects once in a while, but Star Trek Picard didn't even have that most of the time. And so at least invest a few seconds of special effect. You know, we have people online who made the changes to those scenes in season one of Picard when we saw Data, and they actually made Data look younger by using a deepfake technology, and he looks much better than he did in the actual show, and this is made by fans. So I'm definitely going to get into all of that myself. I'll do a whole video just on that topic later. So Data's appearance will be fixed in the fan edit. So anyway, I'm hoping that they will at least show Q as young for a few seconds. As for Guinan, I guess they'll have to come up with some excuse, or just ignore it. Maybe they can say, you know, the species suddenly becomes older at a certain point in their life. You know, Soren did look old in Star Trek Generations, even though he's from the same species. But he did have gray hair, he did look kind of old, and we don't know his exact age, but maybe, I guess they can say the Elorians don't age for a very long period of time, of a few centuries, and then after a certain age, suddenly they start aging like humans, and that can explain why Soren looked old and why Guinan might look old in season 2. And I guess they'll use her to explain how she sees the timeline being changed and all of that. And then Q shows up, even though it's kind of redundant. If we have Q, then why do we need Guinan? Q can simply fill in the blanks and tell Picard all about the changes in the timeline. So Guinan's role in all of this seems kind of pointless if Q is there. And so at least I am hoping that there will be some kind of encounter between Guinan and Q, and maybe they can finally explain that unanswered mystery from back in season 2 of TNG. Of what kind of history Guinan had with Q, why they hate each other, what kind of powers did Guinan have to be able to defend herself from Q, from what we saw in that episode, Q Who? That was never answered, and it's still bugging me that they never explained their whole backstory. And she raised her hands in a defensive position as if she has some kind of power to defend herself against the Q, and he said that she's an imp, she's not what she appears to be, all kinds of mysterious lines like that which were never explained, and so maybe they can finally do it, but somehow I doubt they will. They probably forgot all about it. They just want Whoopi Goldberg on the show just because Patrick Stewart wanted her, probably. So maybe she won't even, they'll forget she had the powers to see alternate timelines. Maybe it will be something unrelated. I guess we'll wait and see. And the Q himself, will he have his powers or not? Because if he has his powers, then we don't really need anyone's help. He can do whatever he wants by himself if he thinks the timeline should be changed. Unless it's some other Q doing the changes, and so he's not in full control. Maybe he doesn't know everything. Maybe he does need Guinan's help for a change. Or maybe he simply lost his powers but still has the knowledge and can still help out as a member of the team. That can be fun, you know, if he's just a normal human with some knowledge that no one else has, then there's a lot of stuff to play with. I think my favorite Q episode is the one in which he lost his powers. That was the funniest Q episode, in my opinion. And him having to deal with it, him having to learn how to be human was fun, even though it would be repetitive to do it again. But at least it will make the show kind of more exciting, and the possibility of him maybe dying or getting in dangerous situations and us being worried about it, it will make the show more exciting and all of that. So I guess we'll wait and see. And so apparently the team is going to go back to the 21st century, maybe to our time, or maybe to the near future, because that's where the timeline branched off into something else. I think the best time to set it would be somewhere in the 2050s, because, you know, right before the nuclear war, which they can say if it went differently, then the Federation will not exist in the same way later on, maybe humanity will not evolve, maybe even they can say someone prevented the nuclear war. But by preventing it, it also prevents humanity learning its lessons or whatever, and so maybe it will lead to a dystopia in the far future, if not for the nuclear war. So that will be interesting, kind of morality-wise. Maybe the team will actually have to trigger the nuclear war to make sure history goes the way it did in the past, and that will be kind of morally interesting that they will actually have to cause the deaths of hundreds of millions of people in order to prevent some even bigger disaster in the far future. And that will be morally shady and interesting, and maybe we'll have some morality dilemmas and all of that. You know, that's what the old Star Trek would have done, but I guess we won't get any of that nowadays. It will just be a bunch of action scenes and people running around, jumping from buildings. So it will probably not be, you know, all the speculations that fans make up based on these little bits of footage are always more interesting than what we actually end up having. So maybe I shouldn't get my hopes up too high because then I'll get disappointed. And we have brief shots of all the characters from the first season, so I guess all of them will be involved. Even that lady who killed Maddox, who she dated, then she got a Vulcan mind meld, which made her see planets exploding. And then, you know, that kind of stuff is happening in all the Kurtzman Trek. You know, even in the 2009 movie, Kirk got a mind meld and saw the destruction of the planets and all of that stuff. Then in Star Trek Discovery, Spock mind melded with the Red Angel and saw the destruction of planets. And now in Star Trek Picard, we see this blonde woman getting a mind meld and seeing the destruction of planets. And so that's kind of repeating the same stuff again and again in all the Kurtzman Trek. So anyway, after seeing that, she killed Mad Dogs, and then everyone forgets about that, and no one puts her on trial and all of that. At least in the new trailer, it appears as if she is in a jail cell. So maybe they did put her in jail at least for a while, until they try her and figure out she's not guilty because it was under the influence of a mind meld, so maybe she's not completely guilty, and I'm fine with that. At least show her for 1 minute in a jail cell being investigated. That will be an improvement to what we saw in season 1, in which everyone forgave her right away and trusted her right away, even though she didn't do anything to earn that new trust after she betrayed them and told their location to the Romulans and killed Maddox, and after that they leave her alone with Picard who was unconscious. I remember laughing at that really hard, of how stupid the writing was in season one. So anyway, at least she's now in a jail cell apparently, but I'm guessing they will break her out or she'll get released right away. But at least she was in a jail cell for a few minutes, so fine. And we see that Seven doesn't have the implant, and apparently she's married. I wonder who will come out of the closet and be revealed to be her husband or her wife or whatever. Maybe it will be someone from Voyager. That will be funny. Maybe she'll be so horrified to find out that she's now straight again that that will make her join the team to go back into the past to fix it. So that's basically all we know from the new footage. I'm wondering if what we saw in the teaser will connect to it, namely that Bajoran artifact, which looks like the same one that Sisko broke in one episode, the one that's supposed to lead to the Bajoran reckoning, the end of days or whatever, the final confrontation between the Pa race and the prophets and all of that. So I'm guessing it will not be a part of the plot in any way. They just put it in the teaser just as kind of an Easter egg for the fans, and it's not going to be, maybe not even show up in the actual show at all. Maybe they just made it for the teaser just to bait the fans into thinking it will be interesting, and in reality it will not be. There will be no Sisko appearance or whatever, I doubt it. And I'm not even sure there should be one, because it's kind of too much. Like, you have Q and Guinan and Sisko and the Prophets, that will be kind of too convoluted in my opinion. So I'm not against convoluted storylines, I love them when they're made well, when they make sense. Even though they're convoluted, but I don't think the creators of the new Star Trek shows are capable of that. They tried to do it, I remember, in season 2 of Star Trek Picard, which did have a very convoluted time travel story, which I kind of liked the ambition of it. I made many long videos trying to explain all of it, but it had major flaws in it, which made the whole thing break down and not make sense in the end, which really disappointed me. So I don't trust them to be able to handle very convoluted storylines, so I kind of hope they will not even try, because I prefer it to be simple and entertaining compared to convoluted and stupid. So that's my thoughts on everything we know so far about season 2, and as for the fan edit of season 1, which I promised will come, it's still in the works. The only thing that is delaying it is trying to get some deepfake improvements to some scenes, as well as some other special effects, which require some time. Most of the idea of the fan edit is complete, and a lot of specific scenes were fixed. They are already on YouTube. You can find them on Major Green. Just type in Star Trek Picard fixed, and you'll see a bunch of scenes which were altered. And in the end, all of season 1 will be like one short movie, which might even be good. And it's been rearranged into a more fast-paced and smooth story, and there are still some choices that I'm not sure about, you know, especially with the Borg stuff, how much of it will be left in, or maybe it will somehow be made into kind of a separate story after the main story. It remains to be seen, and I guess maybe it will be delayed up until the release of the first episode of season 2, just to make sure that the fan edit of season 1 will fit with that better, meaning that nothing contradicts it, because maybe season 2 will actually be good, or maybe it will also be used to make another fan edit of season 2, and so I would want both of them to connect to each other better. And so I guess season 1 fan edit will be released around the time that season 2 starts, just to make sure everything connects well, or maybe even using some footage from season 2 to improve the fan edit of season 1. So the fan edit will probably be released around that time, and by then I hope all the rest of the stuff which is challenging will be complete, like the deepfake stuff, which I am planning to go into myself, and there will be a lot of interesting stuff. I'll make a whole video with just about my ideas of how to use it, and so many interesting and funny potential stuff to do with it, so that will be its own video coming in the near future. So that's it for now. Let me know what you think, and we can discuss it in the comments below, and I will see you all next time. Bye bye.